So it's been a while since I actually made a video like this where we're going over specifics about a series that has ended and one that I specifically enjoyed. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Damo Senpai, and we're here to talk about what's next for ReZero and when do we think we could possibly see ReZero surface again. As you guys know, I make videos about anime and majority anything that has to do with anime, whether it's like JRPGs, mobile games, stuff like that. I make videos on that. So if you guys love anime videos, and I do reviews and reactions, but the reactions are technically reviews. So if you guys enjoy anything of that nature, make sure you go down below, hit the subscribe button or the link in the description. Anyone to help me towards my cause of becoming a full-time content creator. Okay, so let's jump into the specifics because we got a lot of speculation to do. What's next for ReZero? So one of the things we still have is the royal selection. We still need to figure out who's going to become the next emperor. That's like way far off into the future. And with all the strides that Emilia is making to overcome a lot of, you know, her past and all of that stuff, we have so much to look forward to in her character growth and her becoming emperor, because we know that's what it's gonna lead to. Either that or she's possessed by Satila and becomes Satila. So that's a lot in itself, right? We have the royal selection. On top of that, we also have to get Rem back. That is priority numero uno. We have to get Rem back, and in order for us to do that, we need to find the apostles of greed and gluttony. What was so interesting about that is we completely forgot about it, right? We completely forgot about that in chasing after the sanctuary, you know, getting all that taken care of. The way ReZero was written is so good at making you forget what exactly we're really doing. Because think about it, right? We went from losing Rem to getting into Sanctuary to going back and protecting the mansion because it was being infiltrated, to not only protecting the mansion, but saving Beatrice. Not only saving Beatrice, but making Beatrice trust us enough to come to our side and forge a contract with us. And not only that, we also had to defeat the Great Rabbit. And not only that, we also had to uncover all the secrets of the Sanctuary that came with Ryuzu, Garfield, and Rosewall. We had so much to do, and in all of that, we literally forgot about greed and gluttony. That shit is so tight. That was so well done, at least to me. So that presents a lot of what we have coming up, because you have to think about it. If we're still on the road to get Rem back, what are we gonna encounter along that road to getting her back, right? What's gonna be placed in there? We know we still have to deal with all the other witches, their apostles. We still have to deal with all of that. And not only that, we still need to figure out what and who Subaru actually is in this world. What is his purpose? Who is he really? There's so much that we have to figure out. It's going to be batshit crazy. Now, I know a lot of you who read the manga and or the novels, you guys know everything that's going on. You know how much source material we got left. I will ask, this is like the only minor spoiler I will ask you guys to cover in the comment section below, just how much source material is there left? I've never looked into it myself. I've only bought the novels and I've never read them. I had them just for collecting purposes, but just how much source material is left? Is there a lot? Are we too close to the novel or the manga for them to be like, hey, you know, we're gonna announce another season, which we're going to get into a little later in the video. So we've covered the two things that I think could potentially be next for ReZero. Now, let's get into another juicy topic, is when can we expect it back? I need you guys to understand that ReZero Part 1, well, Season 1, that shit came out in 2016. And it wasn't until 2020 that we got ReZero Season 2. So if we're looking at a 4-year gap in between the ReZero seasons, we probably won't see Season 3 until 2024. But here is my theory. With how well ReZero performed and with how well received it was over in Japan, and with all the mobile games getting ReZero collabs and, you know, the ReZero games coming out on Switch and stuff, with how well all that's doing, I don't see why we can't get a ReZero season in 2022 or even an announcement in 2022. I think that could very well likely be on the horizon. Like the announcement of Season 3, I think that if we want to see an announcement, I would say look forward to summer of 2022. That's when I could see an announcement of ReZero Season 3 popping up. I would love for ReZero to come back as soon as possible. I love that anime. It means a lot to me because of the time frame in which it came out and how good it is. It's one of, if not the best isekai anime. I mean, we got Konosuba, but that's a comedy. I'm just talking about like non-comedic isekais. ReZero is the best one. I feel like I've talked about everything that I've needed to talk about. If there's any information that you have in regards to like what could potentially be next, make sure you let me know down in the comment section below. Don't spoil it. Don't spoil it now. That would be much appreciated. Don't spoil what it is. Just like let me know if I'm on the right track in regards to what's coming next. If there's any other nuggets of information you want to leave that ain't spoilers down below, you can leave that down there as well. But with that being said, it's your boy Damo Senpai, and I will see you guys in the next video.